Yeah, so good morning, everyone. I'm from Capillaries, Allahabad, doing an MTech PhD in developing field. Okay, we all know that nanoparticles have been using these days for anticancerous activity. We all know that people are using nanoparticles for anti-cancer treatment, for anti-cancer activity. So like in our lab, we have synthesized many nanoparticles actually, of which two nanoparticles which were of different sizes of silver and copper oxide of 40 nanometers and 120 nanometers, which were showing similar activity of 75 micromole per liter of IC50. IC50 is basically the value that shows the that's the inhibition concentration of a drug which shows 50% inhibition of anything, like any target, cancer or any disease. So that's like generally until now nanoparticles were considered to show the activity according to the size. But here we are seeing that it's a threefold increase and still showing similar activity. So we have decided to what's actually happening inside the body. We have done a simulation for that. So we know that cancer is a major disease in the body, and it's increasing rapidly because of the change in lifestyle and all. So what's the difference between a normal cell and a cancer cell? A normal cell just divides and dies after its life, but cancer cell bypasses this death cycle, that's the apoptotic stage, and it keeps on reproducing, which leads to tumors. Okay. So vasculature, that is the blood vessel, are required for any cell. So these tumorous cells actually form angiogenic vessels, that is capillaries. Okay, and these capillaries help in production, giving the everything from oxygen to nutrients and all. So it is seen that the vasculature of tumorous cells range up to 200 nanometers, where the normal cells generally have only up to 12 nanometers. So, according to research studies, many nanoparticles from ranging from copper, silver, gold, and nickel showed cancerous activity. So, this thing we have done copper oxide and silver. So, how did we select the nanoparticles? Both the silver and copper nanoparticles showed promising results on lung cancer cell lines. The name was A549. And then we have characterized these nanoparticles and found that the diameter of them were 40 nanometers and 120 nanometers. So to model the system on the body, we have used the CAD technique, that's a computer aided drug designing using Autodesk Fusion 360. Okay, we have modeled the healthy with 1 nanometer and 12 nanometer, 1 mm and 12 nanometers as micrometers as per the literature, and then the tumor cells as 200 micrometers and 1 mm. And then we have done computational fluid dynamic analysis using Autodesk CFD 2019. And we all know that the blood pressure is 120/80 and all, but this is a capillary, so we won't be seeing the similar blood pressure over here. The average pulmonary blood pressure is 14 mmHg. So like the conditions that we have used in this thing are in inlet pressure of 14 mmHg and then the temperature, body temperature at 7 degrees centigrade, and this gravitational force is negligible, and the fluid property was already present in the software, so we have used that thing. So like after the CFD analysis, we could see that the velocity was higher in the tumor cell. We could see this graph, and we could even see that the even the pressure actually decreased drastically in case of tumor cell, while it was actually constant in case of the normal capillary. So and then we have nanoparticle retention time analysis to predict the time which the nanoparticle actually reaches the cell. For this we have used mass particle analysis as per the radius that we have got from the XRD results. the mass particles were the silver and copper oxide with the density and ADF as per the studies. And it was found that the minimum retention time in tumorous capillaries was actually very less, but it was actually higher in case when compared to the tumor cell in healthy cells. So that was the result. So from that we could conclude that the because of the retention time, we could conclude that the nanoparticle is actually reaching the tumorous cell faster than the normal cell, which, and we all know that there are many metabolites in the human body, like from ranging from lactic acid to like amino acids and many things, which could actually reducing the cytotoxic effect of the nanoparticle by binding to it. That's one conclusion. And then because there is even the change in the drastic change in the pressure, we could say that the nanoparticles are actually accumulating near the tumor cells, but they are not accumulating in the human, like healthy cells. So this could be used in the dosage studies. So that's